Hey guys, welcome to the Trash Picture Show. Today I'm going to be reviewing the NECA Predators, Berserker Camouflage Predator. Now, I won this guy in an eBay auction. I'm very happy I won him. I won him with another Predator because he is very hard to get now. He was originally part of a two-pack. The other Predator I got was not the Predator that was with the original two-pack. But yeah, I got this guy because he is very hard to get your hands on, and when you do find him in the two-pack is incredibly expensive, but I got him and the other Predator for around 45 euro, which is not bad. And yeah, this guy is the two-pack exclusive. I have another version of Berserker without his mask, but this one is pretty cool, and I'll show you why. Essentially, this is him in his camouflage state, and if I'm not mistaken, this is supposed to be when he shoots Stans in the back and pulls his spinal column out while he's still alive. This Predator was actually portrayed by Brian Steele in the movie. And yeah, he obviously faces off against the Crucified or Classic Predator played by Derek Mears. And I really liked, I wasn't too gone at the start, but as the movie went on, I really liked the design. And it is a very cool design and new take on the Predator. He is essentially a bad blood. He's a leader of a renegade tribe who have taken over a planet and turned it into a personal game preserve. And the idea is these are a more evolved form of Predators. They have either, be it through genetic manipulation or they're simply a different species, have made themselves bigger and stronger. And the little differences and nuances are cool. For example, I love the helmet. The fact as well, he's got a xenomorph jawbone. In the blurb, it says he reached the rank of, I think, elite by killing a xenomorph at a very young age. And yeah, the design is really cool. If you can see there, just the tri-laser and the helmet. The helmet, there's a nice kind of shape to it. The plasma caster is cool. Again, there's sections of this guy that's molded in clear plastic, and it really enhances the kind of camouflage look. I liked the newer version of the tri-laser as well, because it had a rotating barrel like a minigun. So they changed that. Yeah, Nimrod Antal's movie gets a lot of heat. But I think in comparison to the 2018 Predator, this added a lot more to the lore and didn't fuck it up. But anyway, going back to the figure, really nice detailing on the chest, on the armor, the leather strapping. Have a look at the back. Some of his dreads are still cloaked. The back arm here is cloaked. And yeah, really, really nice detailing. And the section of the leg is cloaked. But yeah, it's a kick-ass figure, and I'm glad I got him at such a good price with another figure, because again, this guy was hard to get. Another thing I'm glad I got him for was because he is actually the one of the newer waves of these figures, because originally when they came out, they had very stiff and flimsy joints. They use clear plastic on the joints, whereas these ones don't use clear plastic. And they're a lot more easy to move. Not as much articulation as the newer ones, but still a lot better than the original run. And he does come with two accessories. He comes with these two wrist blades. So you can have one cloaked, or you can have one uncloaked. So we'll show you how the cloaked one goes in. And it pops in just like that. Yeah, he's a very cool kind of cloaked wrist blade there. And I'll put in the other one just to show you what it's like. But yeah, it is a really cool figure. And it's one of my favorite scenes in the movie where he just uncloaks and shoots Stan and stands in the back. And I think Stans tackles him and gives our heroes enough time, but he's so pissed off, he pulls the spinal column out of Stans while he's still alive. And he's just there howling in this kind of wind or maelstrom after an explosion has gone off. And he's just there uncloaking, and he's cloaking, he's glitching and stuff. Again, really cool figure. really happy that I got him for what I did. And yeah, this is kind of what really kicked off NECA's kind of NECA's kind of real kind of collection of the Predator figures, because they had done a run of AVPR figures, which was cool, but the movie didn't do that well. Predator's done a bit better commercially, and NECA saw that there was a demand, and saw there was an opening and produced these figures. And as a result, we got some later figures. We got the Lost Tribe from Predator 2. We got the Predator Anniversary Edition. We got the comic book versions, and so on and so on. And yeah, I think it was the 2010 Predator figures that really kicked off the popularity of the NECA Predator line. And like, they're on, I think, 102 figures so far. And yeah, I've had to kind of cut back on collecting because I'm running out of space. But this guy had to be in my collection. Him and the Greyback. I need to get the Greyback next when he comes out. But yeah, this guy kicks arse. So yeah, guys, what do you think of this figure? Would you prefer the unmasked version of him, which I do have? And yeah, what did you think of 2010's Predators? Did you like it? Did you think it was crap? Did you think it was too much of a departure from the series? Let me know in the comments below. And yeah, have a good one. Take care. Bye now.